It looks so beautiful. Please turn off your notifications. No one cares. Literally, no one cares. Hey guys, it's Katie. Welcome back to my channel. So, in today's video, I will show you how to have a very aesthetic iPad. The first step is to protect your iPad. Now, that implies having a case and a screen protector. My case, I got it off of Amazon. It's like this very beautiful muted rose gold color, and I bought it 2 years ago and I still haven't gotten over it, which is very good. It has this flap, which is composed by 3 long rectangles, which you can fold to create a triangle, and you can put your iPad this way or like this. I will try to link this case down below if you want it, but please don't just buy a case because it looks cute, because a broken iPad with a cute case will do nothing. Just saying. Also, something very important is that you need to clean it. See this? I just cleaned it and it looks so much better. I know it's still dirty, but honestly, it looks so much better than the literally gray I had. It was so ugly and it made me want to vomit. So just clean it and I promise it will make such a huge difference. You will be in shock. And if you are bored of your own case, you can add some stickers to spice it up. Some places you can find stickers are Redbubble, you can support small businesses on Etsy, you can also make your own. Another thing I would recommend is a screen protector. Why? Because if you don't get the Apple Care, I think that's how it's called, then you're basically screwed if you break it or you scratch the screen, because I think you cannot change that. You can do your wallpapers, you can have collages, you can have photos you've taken, quotes, or even a vision board like I do. You can find them on Pinterest, or you can do them yourself by selecting pictures you like and putting them together either using Canva or using Fondo. If you're going to choose a simple photo or a quote, you can find those on Pinterest pretty easily. And if you have other pieces of technology, you can match your wallpapers like I did. It's a really cute way to keep all of your devices coherent. And I don't know, it just makes it feel like you're more put together. This next section, I called it apps because it has everything to do with your apps. There are 2 ways I found that you can organize your apps. The first one is in rainbow order, and that's how I have it. I just know all the colors of my apps, so it's pretty easy for me to find them. Or you can put them on folders. If you don't know how to create folders, it's pretty simple. You just take at least 2 apps that you want to have on the same folder and just press on one of them and then select edit home screen, and then you basically just take your app and put it on top for a long period of time, then you will have a folder. There are also 2 ways that you can organize your folders. You can color code them or create folders based on their functionality. If you're going to color code your folders, I would recommend you change the name of your folders with an emoji of that same color. For example, I would put the cloud emoji because it's white, as well as my apps in here. See, it looks cohesive. And if you're going to classify them with functionality, then you can also use the emoji idea. But for example, this one, it has to do with photos, so you take a camera emoji and you put that as a title. Or you can also write what your folder is about. Personally, I think that everything in lowercase looks more aesthetic, but honestly, it just depends on what you like. This one could be photos. Another tip for this category is to have only the necessities. Trust me, I used to have like 100 apps on my phone. You can literally count them. I made a what's on my iPhone, and trust me, it was one of the stupidest decisions I have ever done, because not only was it overwhelming, but it also occupied a lot of storage on my phone. And to be honest, I didn't use every single app that I had on my phone. There were just some old apps that I had downloaded years ago and I never deleted them. And if you want to be a complete control freak that has everything color coordinated, then you can change the colors of your apps. I know there are apps that change the colors of your other apps. I personally have never done this on my iPad. I had a tablet and I did do that on that. Honestly, just look tutorials on YouTube. And the last tip I have for the apps category is to have Google Calendar, because they look so freaking cute. Oops, I'm late on my schedule, but it's okay because I'm human. But yeah, you can really customize it and it's so cute. And when you sync this calendar to Apple calendars, it looks so beautiful. I'm gonna show you my Apple calendars because they look so beautiful. I just planned my whole 3 days because this is something recent for me, and I would not recommend you starting on Apple Calendar because their colors are ugly. Not gonna lie. So you can customize them on Apple Calendar and make them look cute, and that's it. Now, if you want to know how to synchronize your Apple Calendar with your Google Calendar, it's very simple. Just go to settings and go to passwords and accounts. Then you go on add account, touch on the option that says Google, then say continue. Then you put the email that you are using for your Google Calendar, which I already did. And you can also synchronize your emails, your contacts, and your notes. Once that is done, go to calendar. Then look on the bottom of the page and click on the middle option, which is calendars. And you will see every single calendar that you have open. And if you don't see yours, then just give it a little bit of time. And if you want to be extra aesthetic, you can make them all cute colors that you like. My last category is home screen. Oh my gosh, this next tip, I've never seen anyone talk about this, but it's so important. Please turn off your notifications. No one cares. Literally no one cares, okay? And it also looks very tacky when you see all of your apps and you have like 8,000 emails. It's like, ew. I don't talk to anyone that has more than 1,000 emails unopened because I'm like, I cannot trust you. I cannot trust you. You can see the only app I have with notifications or like the red circle is my settings apps. And that's it. Because Apple is like, oh my god, set up Apple Pay. No, girly, I do not have Apple Pay and I do not want to set up Apple Pay.
Period, queen, you tell them.
And while we're talking about notifications, when you slide down and this pops up, please delete everything you see here. Please, I beg you. And yes, I did leave that on purpose. Again, guys, please remember that this really depends on personal preference. Just because I don't like something doesn't mean you can't like it, and vice versa. You don't have to attack me because I don't like something that you like, okay? Thank you so much. A way you can make your iPad look very aesthetic is to have smaller letters. Now, how do you do that? Open settings, then go to the option that says home screen and dock, and you will see these two options pop up. More will make your apps look smaller. And you can also change your options because, for example, if you want this part to move along your screen, then all you have to do is check this on. This next tip is aesthetic and very freaking useful, trust me. Multitasking. If you don't have multitasking turned on, then you're honestly missing out so much because this is so freaking useful when I'm doing homework and I have to have pages open and also Safari at the same time. All you have to do is go again, settings, then home screen and dock, touch on the multitasking option and turn on the options that you would like. I have them all turned on because I don't know. And yeah, this is how you do it. You basically just touch on an app and then you choose the other app that you want, for example, Procreate, and you drag it and now you have it. And you can also make it smaller. Also, if you don't like this thing like I do, you can always turn it off here. It's underneath multitasking. Now I'm going to show you how to turn on dark mode because some people like it. Again, on settings, then touch display and brightness, which is on top of home screen and dock, and these two things will appear. Just touch dark mode and it will automatically change. And if you like both light mode and dark mode, you can turn on the automatic option. What it'll basically do is it will change depending on what time of the day it is. So when the sun comes down, dark mode will turn on. Another thing that will make your iPad look more aesthetic, but it's totally not necessary, of course, is to make your text size smaller. All you have to do is go on settings, display and brightness, and scroll all the way down. Then the second to last option will be text size, and you just drag this circle until you feel satisfied with your text size. I wouldn't recommend this if you have glasses and you can't really see that well because you will end up forcing your eyesight, which is not good. And you can also turn on bulk text. I don't like it, so I turn it off. It's underneath text size. It looks like this. So yeah, guys, those are all the ideas that I have for you today. I really try to look for newer ideas because I know some people just put the same three ideas and it's like, girl, can you change it up, please? Please let me know if you would like to see a part two of this video because I don't know, why not? I really hope you liked this video. If you did, please like, subscribe, and comment down below what you want to see next. Okay, I love you. Bye!
You mean bread butterflies?
Oh yes, of course.